Here are some of the stories trending this week at NASA. With a roar from its Merlin engines, SpaceX's Dragon cargo ship blasted off from Space Launch Complex 40 at Florida's Cape Canaveral Air Force Station on Friday to rendezvous with the International Space Station. The uncrewed cargo vessel is carrying almost 5,000 pounds of scientific experiments and supplies for the Expedition 39 crew and should arrive at the orbiting laboratory Easter Sunday. Also at the Cape, an important milestone in the history of Florida's Kennedy Space Center Pad 39A. A 20-year property lease agreement between NASA and SpaceX was inked. SpaceX will use and operate the same historic launch site where Apollo and Space Shuttle flights lifted off. SpaceX will act as a tenant and aid NASA and other organizations in sending satellites, ISS-bound cargo, and eventually American astronauts to the International Space Station. NASA's Kepler Space Telescope has discovered a new Earth-sized planet orbiting what could be the habitable zone of a distant star, which means liquid water might exist on its surface. The planet, Kepler-186f, is 10% larger than Earth and orbits its parent star every 130 days. The star is about 500 light years from Earth and is half the size and mass of our own Sun. LADEE, which stands for the Lunar Atmosphere and Dust Environment Explorer, has successfully completed its mission to gather detailed information about the structure and composition of the thin lunar atmosphere. Launched on September 6th, the robotic satellite was designed to last 160 days. However, it continued to provide lunar data for more than 220 days. LADEE ended its mission with a planned deorbit into the moon's surface. Associate Administrator Robert Lightfoot toured the newly renamed Armstrong Flight Research Center at Edwards Air Force Base in California. Visiting with media, he saw the Adaptive Compliant Trailing Edge Project, or ACTE, up close and personal. The Experimental Flight Research Project will help determine if advanced flexible trailing edge wing flaps such as these can improve aircraft aerodynamic efficiency and reduce airport area noise generated during takeoffs and landings. In the early morning hours of April 15th, the United States was in prime orbital position to experience a full lunar eclipse, a phenomenon that occurs when the Earth, Moon, and Sun are in perfect alignment, blanketing the Moon with the Earth's red-colored shadow. If you miss this celestial event, you'll have to wait until the year 2019 to see the next full lunar eclipse from the U.S. And at the U.S. Space and Rocket Center in Huntsville, Alabama, student racers from Nevada's Academy of Arts, Careers, and Technology took top honors in the high school division of the 2014 NASA Rover Challenge. Not to be outdone, Puerto Rico's team claimed first prize in the college division. Over 500 engineering students took part in the event organized by Marshall Space Flight Center, in which the challenge is to design, build, and race a human-powered rover up and over space-inspired obstacles. The experience is designed to provide young engineers new problem-solving skills needed for future NASA missions to the Moon, near-Earth asteroids, and eventually Mars. And that's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on social media and visit nasa.gov/twan.